Hi, and welcome to break. So, this is episode one of break. So what is break all about? Let's see if this picture better. See, I have another one here. So, break is about when we sit at home and think or see something in TV or other places, and we say to ourselves, one time I will go and do something like that, build something like that, when I get time. And often we never get to that. And some people have a muscle car standing in the garage, and one day I'm gonna restore it like new, and kids and works and so on, and time goes, and when we finally have the time, we too old or something else, so get sick or what. So I have decided to take 1 hour a day to the stuff I want to do. And one of the thing is that I think it's 35 years ago, I built this boat. It's a model of the frigate Jutland. It's a Danish warship. Steam and sail frigate, and this is how it looked when it was brand new. I was just finished with it when you see there on the picture, and then we moved around and the time went, and it ended up on attics and down in cellars and whatnot. So it didn't get nicer of that part. So I have for a lot of time been running around and said that when I get time I will restore that again. And like it's kind of like New Year's promise, or what we should call it. It's kind of never get to. So, as you can see, if you see from the top here, if I can, that is very long way to the monitor. That's the wrong one. Just a minute. The setup is new, so so that was better. There it is. Now you can see it's very dusty all over the place if you see down here. And it's nasty and dusty, and all the strings are entangled, and a lot of stuff is broken and broken off and so on. But I will try to keep the strings, because that's the difficult part, or the part that takes at least 1,000 hours to build one of these. And so it worth restoration. So we will make it as fine as the one you see here on the picture again. And after that we will make a lot of other stuff, but you can see this one will take a little time before that is nice again. And a lot of stuff is missing, and but I have it around the safety whistles here are missing on the side of it. You can see here, but I have them. So, and I have a lot of stuff to it, so we can restore it, but it will take time. And I always wanted to make a model of a model theater, and that could be fun too. All kind of stuff. You know how it is with that. And now I will move this, and you would think that I can do it like this. You would think that it was easier to take it in the shower and then give it a good douche down, but it isn't. At least I'm afraid of doing that because it's so dry that it will take a lot of the wood are not painted on the inside, so it will take a lot of water and it will maybe bend or behave like crazy. So I have taken some temperate water here, and then I will just kind of clean it with this and then dry it off out of me. So that I don't get it all wet. Been tempted to just pull it in. And yeah. We miss a chimney, but I have one because it's both sail and steam dragon. And we have it in real size. In a harbor in Denmark. They have restored it, so it's really nice. I have visited a lot of times. See all the cannons that were sticking out here, they are all ended up inside the hall, so that's not that good. I think I'll break this one up. Yes, you can always put it on again. Plastic, so we can fix that apart. some people have an old wall clock they want to restore, or old gramophone or something like that. Just a little bit of soap in the water. So, but this is 35 years of grease. We have to remove but it is a really nice and beautiful ship when it's restored. See, I have just, you cannot see from there, but I have just kind of pulled it up with some strings. You can see all the small cannons are hiding under the dirt. It is tempting just to take it in the shower, but I'm afraid of. Because if it first get really warped, then you cannot fix it anymore. We will spot clean it. two look nice once more. Before this one was restored, it didn't look nice either, the rear one. It was nearly totally destroyed. But today it's really, really nice. So if you ever come to Denmark, then take to Ebeltoft, is the name of the city where this one lays in the harbor. And it's really big, and you can go inside and see everything. Get in here. To get this nasty stuff out. I guess there have been a home for many spiders and stuff. Sorry, I have some paper. And there's no wheel either. But I have some spares. It's all falling apart. Thank you. next time I'll show you some pictures I've taken of it. In real life, maybe I can already. This picture is a little right now. Can you hear? Yes. I was afraid that the mic wasn't the right one. I'll see. Just a minute. It is the right one. Open. Scale to fit. We take another mouse, whatever, and we go on the net to my side, and then we can see it. And go to Pixel Fantasies or in collection. By the way, if you are interested, all my pictures on my site can be downloaded free in full size. So, not just some small thumbnails. Let's see here. I don't remember where I did this one. We have a lot of wooden ships in Denmark. Here you can see one. Here it is. And this one is a real one. It's a foggy morning. We were down there to see it. So it's kind of... Do this mic work? Yes. And see some more pictures of it. I have more from the deck also. He is up in one of the mast. On the deck. See all the cannons. So it's a really pretty ship. So okay, we'll go back to my own. My own little one here. That's not that fancy. But we will hope to make it. But if you are in the vicinity of Grano Ebeltoft, then I would suggest you take a trip down there, because it's worth it, I think, if you're interested in that kind of stuff. I think it's fun to see. see down in the surgery, down in the hall, how the ship doctor amputated the leg of one of the poor fellows that get hit. Seymour. It had been really frightening to be on a ship in a wartime. This was in the Battle of Helgoland. It was just in the time of Admiral Nelson. Romanticize it, but I don't think those poor guys on board think of it as anything or thought of it of anything romantic. I guess the Battle of Helgoland was in 1864, so it's a long time ago, but not that far if you really think of it. Take some time to get this one clean in. And a lot of cotton sticks. Put the lacquer on the deck, so I should be able to. Or who knows how that reacts over time. Good it was 35 years ago. Who knows? But at that time they said it was good. So maybe we should believe. But you can restore a lot of things. And you find an old camera, old gramophone, or old dollhouse, or whatever. If you take your time. And maybe some of you have a grandfather or something who have made some model ships like this and have them on the up on the attic. Who knows? Carpenters that repaired or restored the ship, they really loved it because they could really make old, make it the old way and take the time to do it. So that was a really good time for them. Everything is they made, they did make, and precisely the same way as when they built the ship. now we will see how far we will get with just 1 hour every day. I know a lot of you don't have hours every day for this, but then an hour every weekend. I think it's would have been easier without the rigging, but that's not the case. So and if I do it wet with a shower, then the rigging will kind of tighten up and it will be even harder to fix the wrong stuff. You, I have bent many nuts on this. Or not bent, tight, sorry. Some stairs over on that side and a whole rail up here. Is this loose or what is it? Hanging over here. But finished, they are actually really expensive. You can buy them finished, and then they cost, what is it, $3,500 for this one finished. Worth restoration, I think. Not so much that, but kind of a shame. life, we all get busy with a lot of stuff. Or sometimes not room for it, because it kind of demands some space to have one of these standing around. Try not to get it soaking wet. At least one cannon is looking out. I have carefully painted each one of them. Actually, if we went, no, I cannot. Sometimes you don't remember how you did. What? All this nasty stuff. Mostly spider web. At least it looks much better than we started. We also need the lady in front here. There is no. And she had carved. I don't know where she is. I had her around for a long time, but now I cannot find her. Cleaning the deck. Taking out Didn't they have a young man to do that or something? Look much more promising when we get all this stirred up. It's kind of when I see in the telly or Discovery when I see them make an old barn find. The old car and some of the stuff they take home, I think. My God, when will they ever get that to look to a car, look like a car again? But they do. Some welding and some sandblasting and whatnot, and then they have a car like new. I saw these. It's fun to see how they manage to do it. If it's a copper day, something is broken off here. That's how it is going. You can see this. Yes, this wire here is one I just put on to hold the, or the mast will just drop down. And I don't exactly remember how it sits down in the deck below. It's sometimes difficult to remember. 35 years back, I think it's just glued on a. On the board. Sits in here. Tips out like this. But I have a lot of spare parts, so or else we make them. I guess you can still buy spare parts, but not spare part, but a whole fitting set. You don't need that. A lot of these built as standing around half finished in closets, and of course on the attic and so on, because people didn't expect the time it took. So kind of gave up in the middle then. I often meet people that say, I have one of these two, or one of these also in the closet, but I never get to finish though. Understand why that is. Need to get this. Glue. Take that off with something else. We have beads. Come on. It do look nicer and nicer. Better and better. Even there's a long way to go. Every single one of these are knots. Tight knots. They are not just glued together. Always come a time where you think nobody can see that, but I didn't. Even it was very tempting. Well, I think we will stop for today, because on half an hour I have stop motion. So there's a lot to do and a lot to make, and I have to change the setup so it fits to that part. So I will say thank you for watching, and hope you got a little inspired to do something, or if not, you will think when we are, if it stands nice, like, where is my mouse? I cannot see that here. But it stands like this, then you will think I could have done that too, but you didn't. So no, I understand. Nowadays time is very limited thing, so but it's fun to do, and I hope you will do something, that the car in the garage or something like that. It is fun. So thank you, and see you again, and hope you will follow on YouTube, or Pixel Fantasy Live on YouTube, or on my site, so you look in once in a while on pixelfantasy.com, so we can follow along, and maybe you will tell them your work sometimes. So bye bye. I can't find the button.